Drive, Montgomery County Lifestyle. Hey, good morning, everybody. It's Wednesday. It's a beautiful day outside, and we are getting a boogie woogie on. We got a lot to talk about. There's a lot going on, and there's a lot going on that I don't want to talk about. We are about having fun. We're about talking about positive things. We're about talking about the community, bringing good advice to everybody. But we're going to be going on a little stretch here for a couple of weeks. We've only got 2 weeks left to dive in and do a lot of talking about the youth of our area. We're going to be talking about the Montgomery County Fair and Rodeo off and on for the next couple of weeks. Going to have a lot of young men and women in here that compete. Maybe they raise lambs, goats, pigs, rabbits, friars. Y'all know what a friar is? Go on Montgomery County Facebook, Montgomery County Fair Association Facebook page and find out. How's that? We're going to talk about being a fair queen candidate, what all that entails. Man, oh man, I know that most of you think that that means, oh, I look pretty, I got my hat on, I got my sash, my crown. There's a whole lot that goes into that. And whoever wins the fair queen candidate has to agree to be the spokesperson for a year. There's a lot about that. But folks, the fair and rodeo is a whole lot of what I want to bring to you as Montgomery County Lifestyle. It's community. And it's so many aspects of that community. Let's back up for a minute. So you've got a nonprofit organization that has four like full-time employees, three or four full-time employees. And then you've got a couple of thousand volunteers that are doing stuff throughout the year, but man, they are pedal to the metal right now. It is time to giddy up, and it is in full throttle going out there. So you got people that maybe they're plumbers or electricians or bankers or money handlers, you know, like Cody Bartlett out there. And then you got funny people like Mr. C. Pat Davis, and you've got car dealers, multiple car dealers, a lot of banks that are also the volunteers. And then some of those people are sponsors, and they're giving money to the nonprofit, to the organization that is full focused on getting money in the hands of these young men and women for scholarships, for higher education, to go out and better themselves, better their lives. Some of these kids would not be able to go get higher education at the high school if it wasn't for the way they could earn a scholarship in these programs. I'm going to throw out a wild number to you that's true, but listen to this. Last year in 2016, $1.3 million was given back to these young men. That's right, you heard it. $1.3 million. This isn't, you know, Obamacare fake numbers. This is real Montgomery County conservative truth values money. So then you've got the people, you know, Mom and Dad Smith that bring the gaggle of geese, the five kids out there, and they spend that hard-earned money on getting in the gates. It's $12 to get in on Friday and Saturday and Sunday, both weekends. But for that money, on Friday and Saturday, you get a dadgum good concert. You got Casey Donahue on Saturday night. Giddy up. You've got Mr. Josh Ward on Friday night. Everybody knows these guys. A couple people know them better than others, and you follow them. So you get a lot of entertainment for your money. You got the carnival rides out there. During the week, I think you get an armband for $18, all you can ride. On the weekend, I think an armband is $30, all you can ride. And I don't know about you, but Dick Schistler, Mr. Lone Star Community Radio, y'all can't see him on the air right now. He's just grinning. I think he's either going to buy an armband or he's going to try to twist somebody's arm to get him a free one, because he likes the things that go loop-de-loop and all that crazy stuff. So all us big kids like that too, especially you men out there. You may act tough and macho, but we know you want to get on the loop-de-loop-do and the cups that spin really fast. What else? Golly. And then you got to buy the corn dogs. You know, whether you go to the Lions Club concession over there in the barn, that little show arena, oh man, chili cheese Frito pie with about 35 jalapenos. That's what I eat. That's a given. So now you're gonna go buy food from the Lions Club concession, and the money they make goes back into their own charities to help other people, mainly kids, in our area and around the world. And those are all volunteers. That's a great organization. Go eat their food. And then you've got all the fair food. You've got, you know, the amusement company. They handle all the vendors. They got the turkey legs. Who doesn't want a turkey leg? You got candied apples. Am I making you hungry yet? The popcorn, cotton candy. You got to get the cotton candy on your face and in your hands and in your hair. And so now those people have to pay bills. So you're supporting them. But then a portion of all that money that the amusement company makes goes back to the Montgomery County Fair Association. For what? For scholarships for the young men and women in Montgomery County right here. What else? Man, this is just so far-reaching. Okay. So then you're bonding. So the family who's worked hard all week, mom and dad, some of them had two jobs or a long job. One of them might have even lost their job. And this is their chance to get out in the fresh air, love on each other, laugh, joke, forget about your problems, smile, be happy, and be tight. See your friends, see your neighbors, see people you haven't seen in years. So you're doing that. Then we're going to fast forward and we're going to talk about you've got a special needs day. That's the first Friday. Man, special needs. If any of you get a chance, there's no fee to get out there, to pay to come out there during the weekdays. And on that Friday, the first day of the fair on the 31st, you don't pay till 4 o'clock. Come out there and see some of the groups and the individuals that bring out the special needs men and women and children, but even adults, and see the unconditional beautiful love. And they get to ride rides for free. They get to eat for free. They just got to get there. And it's a beautiful thing. Come out and share that. Be a part of it, especially if you need a pick-me-up. I'm going to give a good buddy of mine, Tim Scott. He's a good dude. See if he wants to come out there and hang out. You've got Kids Day. I think it's Monday and Tuesday the following week. And you've got Senior Citizens Day. If you want to laugh, you need to be out there when you've got those senior citizens. Some of y'all that got some old moms and dads out there, maybe some of them are a little forgetful. Man, you got to get a hold of the fair office and find out. They are a hoot. I know they love candy, too. They take anything that's free, they're taking it. You've got special auctions, like the special needs and stuff, get special auctions. And because of beautiful, wonderful, big-hearted sponsors, which they still need a few, by the way, contact the fair office. They still need a few. All these special needs men and women and children that enter an event and win, and their item gets to go up for auction, sponsors are in place to make sure that it gets bought no matter what. And that's a beautiful thing. And some of those sponsors never really get to see what they've touched and what's happened, but they're touching people in ways that some of us dream and wish we could do. And then you've got the barbecue cook-off the last weekend, Friday and Saturday. And all I can say is, what happens at the cook-off stays at the cook-off. You know what I'm saying over there? It's like 135 barbecue cook-off teams. It's insane. There's music. There's you know, contest, horseshoe, cornhole, washer. And all these people are trying to get the best brisket and the best chicken and the best beans and the best whatever. And it's serious. And there's serious money being thrown out there, sponsors and stuff trying to win. But that is also about the community coming out and just having fun. Wouldn't happen without the sponsors. Wouldn't happen without the volunteers. And none of it would even be in play if it wasn't for the youth who we need to support. So we're going to take a short break, and we're going to bring on our first guest. We got Mr. Mason Mathis and his mama, Lisa. We're going to talk about what it takes to raise animals and what it entails and have some fun. You're listening to Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arrazate. We'll be right back.
Mm-hmm. Lone Star Community Radio is Montgomery County's community radio station, and we are looking for talk show hosts and volunteer DJs for our music shows. Are you interested in having your own talk show on Lone Star, or have you always wanted to live out your dreams of being a music DJ? With the addition of Conroe's FM 104.5 and 106.1 and video aspects of our talk shows, we are needing people to grow with us. If you or someone you know might be interested, please contact us online at irlonestar.com/contact us or call the station at 936-647-5747 for more information.
All right, folks, we are back. You're listening to Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arrazate. And I hope I didn't bore you with my long drawn out, but I wanted to kind of set the tone for what the Montgomery County Fair and Rodeo is and really dive in. And let you guys know it's more than just a fair and rodeo. And the fair, Erica over there and all the board of directors and stuff, they really want the community to know the backstories, the stories behind the scenes and what makes that run. And that's why I have sitting across from me, I have this young man. I met him a couple of years ago, and I lovingly said, man, that dude's a goofball, because he's got a heart of gold. He's got a smile that won't quit. He's got dimples. It's Mason Mathis. And I know his mama, Lisa. I know Daddy Teddy, but Mason, thanks for being here, dude.
Glad to be here, sir.
Good. It's good to see you. Dude, I met you a couple of years ago. Everybody loved you. You were just laughing and joking, and you were. You're a goofball because you had a good heart and you had fun what you're doing.
I believe I am, too.
Yeah. And that's good, man. So we're partners in crime.
Yep.
So let's dive right in.
All right.
How old are you?
I am 17.
Okay. How long have you been showing some sort of animal or entering in an event out at the Montgomery County Fair?
Well, quite a while. About when the time you're supposed to, around seven or eight-ish.
Okay, so you've been doing about 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
What was the first thing you ever entered?
It was a lamb.
Okay.
That was the first thing. I don't think we got into the baking and all that other stuff right the year after, because, you know, we're just getting the feel of it in the very beginning. And that's the biggest thing. You got to get the feel of it.
Can you say get the feel of it? Get the feel of what exactly? What?
Like your environment, how it goes, how the system goes with it, you know, how to show the lamb, how to, you know, sell the lamb to the judge and all that.
So you're out there. You're not just going, hey, come here, little Josephine. Come here. I'm going to slaughter you later. It's a production, isn't it?
Yes.
And there's a method to your methods. There's mm-hmm. a process.
It's a big theater show. You got to sell it. You got to show it. You got to do everything to it.
And that's after you spent 500,000 hours getting up in the middle of the night. God forbid your lamb gets, you know, a lamb cold or whatever, and you got to get mm-hmm. medicine and vet. Wow.
So much stuff to do with a lamb.
What has been the biggest nightmare that you've ever experienced in your 10 years of doing this?
The biggest nightmare is when the lamb goes rogue. When the lamb goes rogue, it gets a little problem because they'll jump, they'll go after, they'll run after to some other place. That's when you have, you know, you got to hold on to the lamb because it will just go out of there. It'll say bye.
And so the judges look at that and go, I don't like that.
Well, yeah, sometimes. Control. Sometimes they do. Sometimes they don't. You never know. It depends who the judge is.
Yep. What has been one of the biggest positive moments for you, one of the biggest takeaways that you're just, if you stop today, you can say, I'm proud.
Mm-hmm.
But what's the biggest thing?
I would say I'll be proud of what I've accomplished in Montgomery County, from the baking to the lamb sales to just the competing against other people. It's a big competition. Can't stop.
So it's a competition, but I see you guys out there too. Y'all are buddies.
Oh, yeah, we're all buddies. We're all buddies until we hit the ring. When we hit the ring, we are all enemies. No one knows anybody. We're going to get them.
So you almost sound like a boxer, man.
Yeah.
You know, you hug before and after, but in the meantime, I'm beating you down.
Yes.
That's awesome.
In and out of the ring.
So what's the highest you've gone with a lamb?
I don't know. It's different every year. Last year, I believe I got 7,000, and it was from Wood Forest, and it was good paycheck. That's a good paycheck, especially right after all the stuff that comes with it.
So they bid 7,000 on your lamb?
Yes.
How much of that 7,000 do you get?
You get a certain percentage. Depends yeah. on how much the fair is going to take away. So,
which goes back into the general scholarship
yes.
fund. So you're getting some money for your time and effort, and that's mm-hmm. cool. But that's money's going back into the scholarship fund.
Yes, it's going to the scholarships.
And you still could get some of that money, so to speak, later because getting a scholarship.
Scholarships are everything around here.
It's everything?
Everything around here. You got to have a scholarship for something at least. And
so you believe in the whole system behind this too. The main mission is community and stuff. But and I don't know the mission statement, so forgive me for that. But I know the mission is to raise as much money as possible to put back in the youth's hands so they can better their education.
Mm-hmm.
And you believe in that?
Yes, I do. I believe in that. Education around here is pretty, you have to do it.
Yeah.
Unless we'll be running around with big old straps in our hands going, hee-hee!
So tell me about your bacon. I know, was it last year, he won something big in the bacon, right? I'm gonna turn it over here Lisa, to Mama real quick.
Hi, Mama.
She's kind of shy, but then once you get her going, oh, Lord have mercy. So what is it about Mason's bacon and stuff that made him so cool?
Well, he practices all year long. And
how do you and Teddy not get like big like me if he's practicing all the time?
We don't eat it. We give it away.
I haven't had any yet. Neither has Dick. So hello, Mason. You can hook some brothers up, okay?
Okay, our next practice, we'll bring some to you.
You got it, buddy.
Yeah, they work on it all year. On the cooking part, they work all year and practice beforehand, and then it's the final, and they enter. And they've always done really well.
So what are you entering this year?
I can't tell you that. That's a secret. If I tell the world, then they're going to know, and they're going to go against me.
So don't tell me what you're entering. Can you tell us what categories?
The jar, canned jars, handicraft. I don't know if it's one or two because they're always different. Pie, cake, mostly cake from scratch because we do that about every single year. Every single year we do from scratch.
Now I understand you've got a little bit of baking in your family history.
Oh, yeah.
Tell me about that.
Yeah.
He's laughing, folks.
I'm like, yeah, we got a lot from Aunt Loretta. She does the catering.
Pasha Fair, right?
Mm-hmm. Pasha
Fair. Pasha Fair. Loretta. Cartwright. Cartwright.
And then we got Miss Marlene Stuber from starting up from my papa's store from back then and to now.
Marlene Stuber, pie in the sky. Still never got my piece of pecan pie. Maybe I'll have to go to, I don't know, Panera or something, you know. But anyway.
She's trying to beat them. just from granny to all of us.
Family tradition.
Yeah, family tradition. That's all we got. Family tradition.
Now, what did you win last year? And didn't you win something in bacon last year, a year before last?
It was yeast breads.
Okay.
Last year, I won grand with yeast breads. And, you know, we're still in the bread. When we go to bread, it's not our real subject. But, like, when we go at it, we'll go at it. We'll just head on.
Yeah.
So, no matter what, go ahead.
I believe he made top 10 in probably all of his entries.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah. And then I think we had to drop one.
Yeah, we had to drop one last year. We had to drop one.
Now, again, I don't know if it was last year or year before last, but I was out there taking pictures of the line that the kids were waiting to get in.
Long lines.
What's the deal? Remember that? Remember me taking pictures?
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, I hollered out something about, hey, ladies, he's single. Who wants to take a picture? Dude, he had young women lined up to take pictures. Is it the dimples?
Yes, it's always the dimples.
Oh, God.
You got to have that smile.
Are you still single?
Yes.
Oh, so now we need to let everybody know.
Oh, yes.
Mason Mathis, he'll be out there all week, and he's single. There you go. All right, so let's back up a little bit. What would you say to somebody else who either is thinking about getting involved, young man or woman, thinking about getting involved, showing an animal, a baked good, whatever, what advice would you give them?
Go for it. It's a wonderful experience to be out there. You know, other than waiting in the line. That's why I go like an hour or two before. I don't like waiting in that big old line. It gets all the way to the opposite gate in the front.
Yeah.
So I would say go for it. It's a great experience. You get to learn a few things. You get to try new things out. It's just a big old ball of fun.
Do you meet a lot of new friends? Do you make some long-lasting, lifelong friends?
Yes, you do.
So you think 30 years from now, there's some people you've met that no matter where you go in this world, you'll always have a tight bond, won't you?
Mm-hmm. Just like my daddy. He knows everybody at the fair. Everybody. Like from his childhood up.
He's like the lamb whisperer, isn't he?
Yeah, he's the lamb whisperer.
That's what I think. They, you know, there's probably people that call him something else, too, because they don't win, but those that he helps, whatever, the lamb whisperer. What would you tell somebody who has done it and hasn't been real successful, and they're thinking about giving up? What would you say to them?
I say don't give up. Don't give up. You know, ask someone. Go to someone to ask for help. That's what most people do for us. You know, they come to us, ask us for help, you know, give them some tips, and we give them tips. We help them out a little bit, how they're showing, how they do it. It's just a big system.
So what days are you going to be out there? It starts on Friday the 31st, and, of course, it goes until a week later on Sunday with the barbecue cook-off, but and that's not what you do, but what will you be doing?
I will be there on the first day of the for the baking stuff, everything, early in the morning.
We're there all week.
Yeah,
it's an all week process.
Yeah, because you've got check-in of one animal or one thing one day, and then you've got a judging, and then after the judging, then
you've
got...
Then you have interviews, and if you make the top 10, then you get interviewed. So it's an all-day process every day.
The entering the lambs and the baking are the same thing. This first thing is the baking, and then probably early in the afternoon, like around 10-ish, 10 or 9, you have to weigh in your lamb and all kind of stuff.
Now, Monday, if I'm not mistaken, Monday is the auction for, like, the baked goods and stuff like that. That's non-livestock auction.
Non-livestock.
So Monday night is when you find out if you got a payoff. If you placed in the auction, then Monday night's when you find out if you got a payoff.
Yes.
Then Wednesday, the 5th, over at the Lone Star Community Center or Convention Center, that's when the livestock auction is.
Yes.
So if your lamb came in and placed big, that's when you find out the payoff.
Yes.
So that's when we're going to see you smiling and jumping up and down, hopefully, right?
Yeah. Hopefully, I'll be all over the place.
Yeah.
It's probably the messiest part of the place because you got cows, chickens, turkeys, lambs, goats, everything there.
Well, we're going to be leaving now. But, right, folks, you've been listening to Mason Mathis, 17-year-old man, young man who's been doing this for 10 years at the Montgomery County Fair and Rodeo. His advice was get involved. Somewhere get involved. Find a way, place to get involved. And he said it's all about getting scholarships. It's all about everybody, community getting involved so that he and others can get scholarships. And Mama, you just love being out there, being proud of your son. I've seen you. And you've got a ton of friends. So it's a community thing for you too, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a family thing too. You know, you get to know all these people and they travel around to all the different shows as well. And then we come home to our hometown fair, and that's probably the biggest to me. I would rather be here in Montgomery County than going to the big shows.
Yep.
You know,
that's getting ready for this, but this is family, this is home, this is the big show.
Yes.
Hey, Mason, thank you so much. I've enjoyed having you. Mason Mathis, go see him out there. He's going to be out there from Friday on. Lisa, thank you for being here. Lisa Mathis, go find her on Facebook. You're listening to Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arrazate, and we'll be right back.
Want to check out what it's like to be on the radio? Need credit for school? For an internship? Then contact Dick online at dick@irlonestar.com. Lone Star Community Radio is Montgomery County's community radio station, and we are here to be part of the community.
All right, folks, we are back. Listen, there goes... Oh, man, you like that, Lauren? Oh,
yeah.
Man, I've got a young lady here. Goes to Conroe High School. She's in everything. And she's sitting there grinning, so she likes this piano. You know who that is? That's Ezra Charles. He is from Beaumont. Lives in Houston. His band for the longest time was Ezra Charles in the Works. That's what he is. He didn't originate it. In my opinion, he did. Texas Real Boogie Woogie. Well, folks, we have Lauren Holtkamp in the studio right now. And she's got a big old following. She's got a posse. And besides her family, and I know her grandpa, she got some good friends. Good friend of mine, Cam Hutchins. He kind of looks out for you, doesn't he?
Yes.
I guess.
Yes. He's a great man.
Yep. So what we're going to do is Lauren is extremely involved in the Montgomery County Fair and Rodeo and a lot of other things associated with that. So, like I said, we're going to go on for the next couple of weeks, have a lot of shows bringing in sponsors, bringing in the people that are involved that are participants, bringing in some of the volunteers. So, Lauren, Thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me.
And tell everybody a little bit about you, who you are, what you do, and then tie that into the involvement in the fair and rodeo.
Well, I'm Lauren Holtkamp. I've been involved in the fair for the past 10 years. I've been in 4-H since the third grade, and the fair has provided me many different opportunities where I could express myself and be involved with my community. I participated in the Fair Queen competition last year, and I received the title of first runner-up Fair Queen.
Wow.
Which was really awesome. It was a really cool experience, and I got to meet 17 wonderful girls, and I put a lot of hard work into it, and I'm just really honored that I received that title. Also, I'm involved in the Junior Fair Committee, and I've been involved since my freshman year. And they just developed it 4 years ago, and it's where the youth can become involved in the fair. And they work anywhere they put you. I know I'm working Friday in the fair office. I'm delivering invitations and putting them in the mail. And I'm also working the wristbands, putting wristbands on people when they come in.
Oh, because Friday is Special Needs Day.
Yes.
Oh, man. I'll be out there. I'll be out there every day. I'll be out there 8, 9, 10, 12 hours every day. So I'll see you. But that's a wonderful day.
Yes.
Did you pick that day or did they just kind of assign it to you?
I believe it. I went on their email. They send you out an email and you put what you want to do. And I signed up for it.
Cool.
So, yeah.
So what else?
I won reserve champion cake last year. It was my first time to make the sale, which was pretty exciting.
What'd you make?
Well, it was a pineapple wedding cake, and you put pineapple and sugar on the frosting, and what makes it really good is the pineapple juice makes it so moist. So it was really good, and it was something very memorable I could share with my family, and my brothers made the sale for the past 2 years. He's so lucky. So, you know, we've all been working really hard, and I'm just blessed to have supportive family and supportive parents, you know, that want us all to be successful, and that's what the fair is all about, you know, giving back to your community. And, you know, I'm just thankful that we have wonderful leaders in our community that want to help us, and they want to help us and invest in our future, which is really exciting. And I'm excited to be an Aggie. Whoop! Kick him.
Erica, that was for you. Erica Imhoff is an Aggie, too. Yeah, Brady and all that Walding clan. You know, what's up with that, man? You know, a million years ago when I graduated high school here, there was more hook'em horns, longhorn stuff than that whoop-whoop thing. What changed?
I'm not sure. I guess it's just the people, you know, solid people in our community.
I'm going to blame it on Austin. The liberals in Austin, they made Austin weird, so now, you know,
yeah. That's
just it. So that's what I'll say.
There you go.
You mentioned something I want to come back to, because for a young lady that's pretty wise, pretty big thinking, give back to the community. How are you giving back to the community by your involvement?
Well, I did the Special Angels Rodeo. It's a rodeo for special needs children. I did it for the past 2 years, and we're going to do a third one. And it's just, I provided opportunities for children. We had adaptive rodeo events, carnival games. We had a horse at the event for the children to ride. And it was just something for them, for their families, you know, a day of fun and just something they can remember and cherish and something they can look forward to.
And I know you had a lot of volunteers and you needed sponsors to help pay for it. So
yes. By
doing that, and I know you know this, but to those listening, because we partnered up to try to help a little
bit.
And I know that she was so adamant, so worried about making sure that she could thank her sponsors, making sure that she could thank those that were getting involved, whether it's, you know, saying the Pledge of Allegiance at the beginning, writing a check for $100 or $1,000. In fact, let's take a moment. Don't know if they're listening, but we're going to share this podcast on YouTube. Thank some people about that, because that was a huge day.
Wood Forest Bank helped us a lot. Conroe Feeder Supply, Conroe Regional Hospital, the Willis Lions Club also really helped us. They provided the bucking equipment. Those are the sponsors.
Yeah. So how is the community helping the youth by getting involved in the fair. In your involvement, what are some of the things you've seen people do out there that you think is a direct impact that comes back to help you and your friends, the youth?
Well, they're all super supportive, and they're just willing to give and help us, you know, for our future. They're willing to invest in our future, and to me, that's wonderful, because we all work so hard year round on these projects, and it's just wonderful that they are willing to give to us. So.
Now, what did you enter and win in all last year? Because I know you do a lot.
Yes, I won Reserve Champion Cake, and this year. I'm making a quilt. I'm doing a ooey gooey cake. And I'm entering a photo. So those are my three this year.
Now, when you do that ooey gooey cake, do you make a couple of them and then right before you turn them in, decide which one looks the best?
Yes, yes. Okay. There's a lot of practice runs, but yes, I picked the best one.
Well, we're going to tell you what we told Mason Mathis, because mm-hmm. he bakes too. This is Dick Schisler, the owner of Lone Star Community Radio, and I'm with him every Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday from 11 to 12. So if you've got something, we don't care what it looks like. You know, you could just drop it off and say, hey, give me your opinion, and we would share that with other people just in case you're interested.
Okay,
you know?
I'll keep that in my mind.
What all are you entering this year, and what did you say, a quilt?
A quilt, cake, and a photo.
And a photo. Are you? You probably don't want to tell us what the photo is, do you?
Mm-mm. Okay. Surprise.
Is photography something you're dabbling in? Do you do it a lot? Tell me about
it's
that.
It's fun. We went on a cruise this summer, and I got some cool pics. So.
Oh, yeah. See there, folks. Secrets out. It has to do with cruise. Not Tom Cruise. Went on a cruise on the water. So, what would you say? And I know that you're such an upbeat, God-loving, just wonderful young lady, but there's probably some heartache or heartbreak or not so happy times in this whole experience. Is there ever been a particular event that you were in that it just didn't turn out the way you wanted and just bugged you for a while? Or
yeah, when I was in the fifth grade, I entered a painting, and I interviewed for the top 10, and that year, I believe they only took 4 to the sale, and I made 5th. So I worked really hard, and it was just hard for me, but, you know, that's just a challenge you have to go through, and it's life.
Yep. Well, and also, there's not an event yet, but maybe someday, I don't know, will you be, your horse's name is Brown?
Big Brown, yes.
Big Brown. Will you ever be doing some barrel racing in that arena?
Yes. Well, I know there's a CPRA rodeo, but... I've done some barrel racing in there for 4-H.
Is there, during the rodeo, is there barrel racing in that rodeo?
There is, but not for the youth.
How old do you have to be?
I think you have to be in CPRA.
So you have to be in that.
You have to be in that association, I believe.
So we need to figure out what it takes to get you in there, because yes. I heard, a little birdie told me, you and Big Brown were pretty daggum good when it comes to barrel racing.
We work hard.
Yep. Yes. And he was cool. He was in some of the videos we took.
Yes, yes.
He wanted to be in the limelight. That was awesome.
Oh, yeah, poking his head in there.
Yeah. Well, folks, we're going to take a short little break. And when we come back, we're going to ask Lauren to talk to us about, there's one particular committee that she's on that she's really passionate about. And she wanted to make sure that she get to talk about that and the people she's on there with and certain things about it. So we'll be back, Lauren. You're listening to Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arrazate, and we'll be right back.
We're starting to film our talk shows and putting them on YouTube. Your favorite Lone Star Community Radio show can be seen on YouTube under our Lone Star Community Radio channel and on City of Conroe's Our City TV channel on Suddenlink Channel 12. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see the most recently released videos and find more information online at irlonestar.com/TV.
All right, folks, we are back. Look, we get busy. This stuff just keeps going and going. We could be here for hours boring you or making your day happy. So what we're going to do is we're going to talk to you about, I need you folks, whether you're listening live right now, whether you're listening to the podcast, which is coming out a day after this, came out today, Wednesday, or you're watching us on the YouTube video that usually comes out about 2 days later, I need you to go right now to Facebook. Go to the Montgomery County Fair Association Facebook page. Go find five National Anthem finalists. Now, in fairness to everybody, pick one of those five that you think is the best and the coolest. But while we're here with Lauren, we're going to say we think it'd be cool if you picked hers. You have to like the Fair Association page, like her video, and then share that video. Whoever gets the most likes and shares gets to sing the national anthem at the rodeo, right? Wow, that's a huge thing. So, Lauren, we're going to ask you, because I think it's the most beautiful song that God ever penned to anybody, other than Just As I Am, which you can only hear in church. Would you sing the national anthem for us here? You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Oh, man. Thank you so much. Folks, it was so cool. I'm looking outside the window over here, and I'm watching people walking by, and they stopped, and they're looking, where's this coming from? Because we got speakers outside.
Yeah.
Okay, beautiful voice. I loved it. But I got to tell you, from my heart, I am an old-timer. I'm stodgy, and I'm set in my ways. You sang that the way it was written. No vocal vibrato, no look at me. My voice can shake and shatter and shudder and go around. That is the perfect and only way to sing that song, in my opinion.
Thank you.
That is beautiful.
Thank you.
Folks, go to Montgomery County Fair Association Facebook page. Please go to her finalist number five, like their page, share it. But look, in fairness to everybody, if you see one of the other four finalists and you want to go their way, you know what? Even Lauren says, hey, that's fair. That's fair. Either way, let one of them win the honor. Wow. I think we're going to record that, Dick, and I think that I'm going to have that play on more of my shows. Thank you.
Aww, thank you.
Okay, took my breath away. We've only got a couple more minutes. Tell us about the Junior Committee.
It's just a group of us youth that want to volunteer and give back to our fair. And we've done many different things throughout the year. We've done Toys for Tots Drive, and we gave back to our community in that way. We also have visited the Capitol, Austin, which was really cool. We represented the fair there, and we love to give back, and we want to give everything we can to the fair. We're just a group of hard workers that love the fair and love our community.
How many people are in your committee?
I would say 70, or it's close to 100, but there's a lot. A lot of youth that really care about the fair, and they love our community, so that we all work really hard.
You build some good friendships and bonds, don't you?
Yes, yes. Great people that I'll have for the rest of my life.
And we've only got about a minute or so left, but tell us a little bit about the path of Fair Queen candidate. I understand that's pretty hard. What are some of the key things you have to do to even have a halfway chance of being the Fair Queen, which last year was Bailey Carwall, right?
Yes.
Awesome.
She's wonderful.
Yep.
You just have to practice, and work really hard, because I remember I wrote my speech, and I started practicing in January, and the fair is in April. So So I worked really hard. I practiced with an apple in my hand as a microphone. I wore my outfit, what I was going to wear the day of, and I practiced in the mirror, saying it to my parents, saying it to my grandparents, saying it to everyone. And I worked really hard on my speech, and it's really taught me skills that I can take for the rest of my life, because I also had to go through an interview process. And so it will help prepare me for a future job, and it's just a great experience, and anyone who has the chance to do it, I recommend going to do it. It's just wonderful, and it's made me become the person I am today.
Awesome. Well, I just want to say this, folks. Over the years, I've learned more about what a Fair Queen candidate and Fair Queen is. It's not just about being a pretty face. In fact, you know, it's not about having to be a perfect face or perfect nose or eyes or perfect figure or whatever, perfect hair. It's the whole package. It's having a brain. It's caring yourself, being smart, it's being caring, it's being about the community. So on that note, I just want to say thank you, Lauren, for being here. Thanks for sharing your experiences. I hope that's inspired some others to go show and get involved, be a Fair Queen candidate, be in the junior committee, go buy a ticket, go online and get your tickets and come out there and support you guys. And I thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
My pleasure.
It was fun.
Folks, you've been listening to Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arrazate. I've got another show tomorrow, Thursday, from 11 to 12. We're going to talk about Challenge Air and what that's coming up April 22nd and how that helps special needs people. Friday, got a great day. Conroe Transportation is going to be here. And we've got Gabby, Laura,
Gabby.
Yep, who is also part of the Fair Association. We're going to be talking a little bit more about that. Go to Montgomery County Fair Association's page, find out about it. Go to Montgomery County Lifestyle, find out more about me. Go to Lone Star Community Radio, find out more about us. Community Radio, the community, and how you can get involved. Folks, thank you very much. Have a great Wednesday. You've been listening to Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arrazate. It's not about me, it's about you. And this is your county, your life, and daggummit, folks, it is your style.
It's 11:55.
Thanks for checking out this recording from Lone Star Community Radio. Lone Star Community Radio is Montgomery County's community radio station and broadcasted live from Conroe, Texas on IRLoneStar.com and Conroe's FM 104.5, 106.1. Interested in sponsoring this show, being a guest, hosting your own show, then please visit us online at IRLoneStar.com and check out the Contact Us page. We want to say thank you to our studio supporters, our traffic sponsor, Conroe Americana Music Festival at conroeamericanamusicfestival.com. For more information about the show, please check out the information below in the description.